Hi, welcome to Lofuma Solutions. In our previous discussions, we looked at derivatives. We said that the process of differentiation results in what we call derivatives. And actually, talking about derivatives, just looking at the behavior of a function with respect to the independent variables. So for instance, if you have a certain function, let's say f of s equals maybe x squared plus 2. We find the derivative just f prime of x giving us 4x. So for instance, this gives us the first derivative. But in this video, what we're going to look at is higher derivatives. And talking about higher derivatives, just about second derivative, third derivative. So any derivative of a function more than once gives us higher derivative. So if you have this, then finding second derivative of this, for instance, gives us 4. And third derivative here will give us 7. So you can look at this and this as higher derivatives of this particular function. But given any function, for instance, y equals f prime of x, then the first derivative here is going to give us say dy ds. So when we differentiate this again, it gives us that second derivative now, which is the square y ds. So you have something like that. The third derivative gives us something of this nature, and you realize that this can continue. So if this continues up to n minus 1 derivative, so that we're going to get the n minus 1 y dy, so you have ds n minus 1. We're looking at the nth derivative, so nth derivative gives us the n y then dy. So we look at all these things as higher derivatives. Then what we want to look at more specifically is to try to derive certain higher derivatives for specific functions. Okay, so let's take the cosine. So you're looking at so we're finding the f derivative of sine. So we're going to look at the nth derivative of sine x. But so what we do is that we say y should be equal to sine x. So we have something like this. And we differentiate that the first derivative. So if you differentiate sine s, we'll get cos s. So cos s. Okay, so we need to find the second derivative. So y prime prime, we're going to give us sine s. But we realize that when we differentiate this and we get cos s, using compound angles, we can say that cos s here is equal to sine x plus pi over 2. This is actually true because when we're doing the expansion of this, for instance, sine x plus pi over 2, so this will be equal to, so you're having sine x plus pi over 2, then plus cos x sine pi over 2. So cos pi over 2, which cos 90 gives us 0. So it makes all these places become 0. But sine pi over 2, which sine 90 gives us 1. Multiply that this will give us a cos. So it's appropriate that we write cos x as sine s plus pi over 2. So let's just, by the way, back to business. We now want to find the second derivative. So by this line, we will now concentrate on this. Once this is again the same as this one, it's equal to this. To find the second derivative, now we rather differentiate this aspect. So differential of sine gives us cos. So you have cos. And we look at the arguments, there is x plus pi over 2. Then we would like to, because it's a composite function, so we just want to differentiate what is inside here. Differential of x gives us 1, but this is a constant. When we differentiate it, we get 0. So it means this will be multiplied by 1 and we still have the same thing. So let's look at the third derivative. What we're trying to do is to build a certain procedure and see certain pattern so that we'll conclude that the nth derivative of sine x is equal to whatever we get. So, but this particular one is going to be the same as sine x, let x plus pi over 2 plus pi over 2. So this gives us, so we're going to have pi. Now if you use, if you expand this like I did in the first case, you see that whatever is here is the same as what we have here. So find the third derivative. Yeah, we'll not go for this, but we'll go for its equivalence. So derivative of sine s gives us cos s plus, so you have pi over 2 plus pi over 2. Then you can guess the equivalence of this one. So it actually is going to be sine s, so you have sine. So here there's no x, so it's sine here. So sine x plus pi over 2, pi over 2, then pi over 2. So this one, I have three of them there. I think the pattern is forming already. And let's look at the fourth derivative. And if you did that, you get in cos x plus pi over 2 plus pi over 2 plus pi over 2. And it's going to be equal to sine so x plus, so we're going to have pi over 2, pi over 2, and pi over 2, and plus another pi over 2. Now, what we have realized is that I hope you have seen with me that in the first derivative, see what we differentiate first, then there is x plus pi over 2, so pi over 2 is 1 at this moment. The second derivative means that we now have pi over 2 twice, or two of them. The third derivative results in pi over 2, pi over 2, pi over 2, three of them. Then the fourth derivative, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. So on this basis, it is appropriate that when I say fifth derivative of sine s, you will tell me that it's going to be s, the sine s, then plus. So we have pi over 2, which will occur 5 times. So on that grounds, we say that let this process continue. So if it continues up to the nth derivative, okay, so you're going to have sine, so x plus. So the number of derivatives is going to be the same as the number of pi over 2s that we have. So this gives us n pi over 2. So the derivative of sine s, if you want to differentiate sine s n times, n number of times, then it is simply given by this thing that we have just arrived at. You can always test it. So if you want to find the first derivative, you just put 1 here. That means first derivative, and you're going to put 1 here. So that gives us sine x plus, so pi over 2. Now if you expand this like I did first, you see that you get to guess cos, cos x. And it's true because when we differentiate sine x, you get what? Cos x. Yeah, so we'll look at this and that's good. Yeah. So I hope you have found this very helpful. Thanks very much for watching. We shall meet again to look at the nth derivative of ln x, that's the that particular function, how to derive its nth derivative in a whole root. You can't afford to miss the next video. Alright, see you next time. Bye.